Let's take it to Ireland now and talk to the CEO of Davenport Resources, Dr. Chris Gilchrist is standing by. Dr. Chris, always great to talk to you. Give us an overview, first of all, of Davenport.
Good morning, Polly. Davenport's been listed on the ASX since 2016. It was vended from a shell acquired by one of our directors, Rory Luff, for the purpose of acquiring and exploring two exploration license areas in central Germany in a highly prospective potash area where there had been previous potash mining. We subsequently purchased three perpetual mining licenses from the German government, and we now control over 650 square kilometers under license, which hold more than 5.3 billion tons of potash resource, which was confirmed by third party Micon International, and which represents the biggest potash resource in Western Europe.
How important is potash right now? We know it's used as a fertilizer in agriculture, but what are global inventories like, and what's demand like?
Well, potash is actually a general term for any compound which from which potassium becomes soluble. So there's different forms of potash. The most common form is potassium chloride, which is known as MOP, or muriate of potash. It's one of the three most important components in the fertilizer, which are necessary for plant growth. The other two are, of course, nitrogen and phosphorus. Most fertilizers contain three elements, and therefore they're called NPK fertilizers. So potash is very important in that respect. The world's population is currently over 6 billion inhabitants. By 2050, it's forecast that the world's population will increase to 9 billion, which is a massive increase. Clearly, food demand will increase in proportion with the population demand, and also eating trends or dietary trends are changing as people become a little bit richer. And of course, you can see that potash has completely different drivers from other commodities. And as I say, Argus, Integer, and CRU, the principal experts in terms of marketing of fertilizers.
So they, is there enough potash, if I may interrupt, in the world, and what are the inventories like?
Well, CRU and Argus forecasted potash demand will grow by between 2 and 3% per annum. So the world market currently stands at about 68 million tons. By 2050, it probably will be over 100 million tons. So there certainly is plenty of scope for new players to come into the market and sell potash.
Let's talk a little bit about yourself, if we may. You've been in the mining industry, Chris, for years now. Give investors who haven't heard about you and your incredible pedigree a little overview of your track record and indeed what attracted you to Davenport Resources in particular.
Okay. Well, I'm actually a metallurgical engineer by first degree, and I achieved a master's and I did a doctorate in mechanical engineering. I had 10 years with Goldfields in South Africa and 11 years with DeBeers in South Africa in the diamond industry. I was actually DeBeers' first mine manager, who was not a mining engineer, which broke with tradition, but nevertheless, I enjoyed it very much. I was transferred to Anglo American's Cleveland Potash Operation in 1998 in Northern England, and stayed there for 7 years, and that's where I learned all about potash. I then became Chief Operations Officer for an Irish company called Kenmare Resources and built a $500 million mineral sand operation in Mozambique, and that's basically why I'm based in Ireland. In 2008, I actually started my own sort of consulting business, and subsequently have assisted potash projects in Argentina, Russia, Germany, the Congo, Ethiopia, Eritrea, and Kazakhstan. So people call me Mr. Potash, and anything that happens in the potash world, I usually get a phone call or an email or something like that. So for my sins, certainly became a potash expert as such. What attracted me to Davenport, I think it's very unique. Davenport acquired very valuable mining licenses in Germany for a very low amount of money. I think that it can be a powerhouse for European potash production, because German mines owned by Kalian Salts are going to be closing down in the next 5 to 8 years. And I think we can take over as a European potash powerhouse.
All right, let's get down to basics then. Let's talk about Nora Allende and indeed the latest set of results that have come out. There's been a technical study, hasn't there? What did you make of it?
It's fantastic. We're delighted. The Nora Allende field represents the northern part of the massive Mulhausen field, which contains in total 2.8 billion tons of resource, which is unbelievable. The southern part of the Mulhausen field contains over 800 million tons of high-grade and thick sylvanite, which is the ore of first choice. The Nora Allende field contains mostly carnallite, which is a potash ore from which you can produce potash, but it also contains magnesium. The carnallite seam is up to 45 meters in thickness, which is huge. And apart from potash, it's very rich in a mineral called kieserite, which is magnesium sulfate, which is highly sought after as a fertilizer additive. And kieserite can command up to $400 per ton. We commissioned our consultants, KU Tech, in the local area to conduct a preliminary study on Nora Allende. And they've reported we could build a mine which would produce 575,000 tons per annum of potassium chloride and 640,000 tons per annum of kieserite. The capital and operating costs for those are extremely competitive and certainly stand well above or well below global averages at this time. So we're very excited about the Nora Allende results.
And do they fit in with Davenport's plans for your future projects?
Very much so. Davenport's begun a process to attract a strategic partner to develop these projects. To this end, we've assembled a data room, information memorandum, and basically everything that a strategic partner would require for a due diligence process. We are currently engaging with several potential partners under non-disclosure arrangements, and we hope within the next 3 months to have secured a partner that we can work with. We've identified Ongeberger as a potential starter project. It's whilst it's our smallest license area, it's also our shallowest license area, and there are operating shafts in the vicinity which we may or may not be able to utilize in order to minimize capital costs for the start of the project.
Chris, that's a great overview on what Davenport's up to right now in the potash space. What are we looking forward to then over the next 4 quarters from Davenport in terms of news flows? What will investors see?
Well, the priority is to engage a strategic partner, and we've worked very hard to put together a data room and the various different information that a potential strategic partner would require. And we've attracted quite a considerable amount of interest from potential partners. So we're very optimistic that within the next 3 months, we will have a partner on board. We then would require to drill at least 2 holes in the Ongeberger area in order to convert the inferred resource to an indicated and a measured resource. And we would expect to do that by year end. And that would enable us under the ASX regulations to declare or to announce the results of our scoping studies, which we have to hand, but we can't announce them at the moment because we've only got inferred resources. So that's really what the investor could expect for the rest of the year.
All right. Well, when you've got the results of those scoping studies, do come back and tell us first. But for the moment, Dr. Chris Gilchrist, thank you very much indeed.
I'll be delighted to come back and tell you all about them. And thank you for your time. Thank you very much.